Hello everyone and welcome back to our math content series video. And today's problem, we're going to be going over a very simple perimeter problems, and that's what we're going to be doing today. And also the difficulty level for these problems is for grade 7 and for grade 8. So let's get started with what the problem is. So our question here reads, in the diagram, the perimeter of the triangle is equal to the perimeter of the rectangle. So what is the value of x? So basically the important keywords that we can pick out from this sentence here is that the perimeter of the triangle, so the perimeter of the triangle is equal to the perimeter of the rectangle. And then we need to find out for the value of x. So we know that the perimeter of the triangle is equal to the perimeter of the rectangle, and then we just need to find x. So this is basically what we need to find for this problem. And now let's look over our possible answers. So we have A, which is just 8, we have B, which is 10, we have C, which is 11, we have D, which is 14, and we have E, which is 15. So these are our possible answers for this problem, and also now feel free to pause this video if you needed to solve this problem by yourself, but if you don't need any assistance, then we're going to be going into this problem right now. Okay, so first to solve this problem, what I'm going to do is that we're going to define the perimeter. So I'm just going to draw a line here for both sides, for the triangle and the rectangle. So on the left side, we're going to do the perimeter of the triangle is equal to, and if you forgot, the perimeter is just all the sides added together. So the perimeter of the triangle is basically just A plus B plus C. So that's the perimeter of the triangle, and the perimeter of the rectangle, so perimeter of rectangle, is equal to 2a plus 2b. So here we just defined what is the perimeter for both the triangle and the rectangle, and now let's just fill in our values for what we have right now. So let's start off with the triangle, because here in this diagram, we can see that the triangle, we already given some values, which is 14 centimeters at the top, and then 12 centimeters on one of the sides, and it shows that we have this line here, which means that both of the, those sides, this side and this side, is equal. So that's what those lines mean. So what we're gonna do, since we already know that one of the sides is 14, what we're gonna do is we're just gonna say the top one here is A, this one here is B, and this one here is C. So we already know that A is going to be 14, and we know that B will be 12, because we can see that this line on the other side is also 12, so we know that B is going to be 12. So we're going to have B as 12, and also C will also be 12. So this is our values for the perimeter of our triangle, and if we add those all together, then we get 38 centimeters. So that is the total perimeter for our triangle, and now let's start simplifying for our rectangle. So we already know that the perimeter of a rectangle is 2a plus 2b, and we're already given 1, which is 8 centimeters, and we also are given x centimeters. So we already know that since 8 is 8 centimeters, we know that this side is also going to be 8 centimeters. Those are equal. So then we're going to just do, instead of 2a, we're just going to write 2, and then in a bracket, we're going to put 8. So that we're just filling in the a, so then we have 2 times 8, and then we're just going to do plus, and instead of 2b, we're going to just put 2x. Sorry, that was a bad looking x, so 2x. So this is how our equation looks like now, and now we're just going to start even more simplifying it. So if we do this, then we have 2 times 8, which is 16, plus 2x. So now what we know is that we already know what the perimeter of the triangle is, which is 38 centimeters. And so far we have almost completed the perimeter of the rectangle, and now we just need to find out what the value of x is. And to find the value of x, we're just gonna combine both of these equations together. So I'm just gonna pick a different color here. So what we're gonna do now is we're just gonna merge these two together. So to do this, all we're gonna do is do 16 plus 2x, and then we're gonna just write equals to 38. So by doing this, we're just saying that the perimeter of the rectangle is equal to the perimeter of the triangle, and that's why we're solving for x. So from here, what we're just gonna do is we're gonna move the 16 to the other side, so then we can like isolate the variable by itself. So then once we do that, we're gonna have 2x equals to 38 minus 16. And then if we do 38 minus 16, then we get 2x is equal to 22. And after this, then we're just gonna bring the 2 over to the other side as well. So we just isolate the variable by itself. And by doing that, we're just dividing both by 2. So it's gonna be x is equal to 22 divided by 2, which is basically just 11. So here we found out what our x is, and we have x is the value of 11. And that means that the x centimeters is actually 11 centimeters. So just like this, we found out what the value of x is for this problem, and that's basically how you solve this problem. And that's also basically it for our perimeter problem. So thank you so much for watching from Try to Be Useful, and we'll see you guys in our next Math Content Series video.